Let's bring in our next guest. He hopped on a snowmobile in Buffalo to help rescue dozens of people and animals stranded in the storm. William Kless joins us now. William, you told our local Fox affiliate this week that so far you've rescued more than 50 people. Some of those people have gone on record now saying they believe they would be dead if it weren't for you.
Yeah, it's been pretty hectic up here in Buffalo, unfortunately. You know, we didn't underestimate, you know, what was going to happen here with this storm. And when we took the snowmobiles out, me and my buddies, we didn't expect to, you know, we saw the reaching outpost and we expected just to get a few done. And it just turned into a 3-day thing. And it was just nonstop for 3 days. And so many people in need of just food and shelter and warmth. And, you know, over the 3-day period of time here, you know, we got so many people back and forth. Actually, now that the power's on, we're actually still slowly taking our vehicles because we can transport them from the church that Al Robinson over there has in the Lovejoy District that helped us out big time with everything. I'm picking them people up that can't physically get back on the sled that we had a rough time getting them there already, back home safely now in the truck so everybody can be, you know, back comfortably home and stuff like that.
We got some video of you rescuing Eddie Porter. I want to play that for our viewers so they can see. So they can see some of this work you've been doing. Talk to us about either Eddie or another story that really sticks with you.
Yeah, no, Eddie really sticks with me, and Eddie stayed strong. And when I met Eddie at first, he was at the gas station when we were refueling up after helping out so many families. And that was the designated route that you see me taking Eddie up Gold Street there from East Lovejoy by the fire hall. And when I was fueling up and there were so many people at the store on East Lovejoy and North Ogden, Eddie was one of them with his brother, and I think it was his brother or possibly his friend, that they asked if they could, you know, get some shelter or somewhere warm. And I said, as soon as I get back taking these people right here, we'll be right back. So I made a promise to everyone that was in need. And once that, you know, opened up the door right there with Eddie, everybody in the store was like, can you get me here? Can you get me there? And it just turned into a round around so many times. And then when I got to the church, I worked with Al. I got his phone number, personal phone number, and he gave me a list of every address that we could go and help him more. And we reached out to so many. And one of the pictures that you guys have on there, like that one right there, this lady is 88 years old. As soon as we're done with this interview, we got her safely back to her brother's house on Green Street. And she wants to go back to her house on Longnecker. She just wants to, she wants to feel comfortable there. But until we made sure her pipes were good and her heat was working, we didn't want to move her too many times. So we moved her from the church yesterday to her brother's. So they are home with heat at his house. Now we're actually, as soon as we're done here, we're going right to her house on Green and getting her from her brother's and taking her to her personal house.
Amazing. Yeah. What made you get involved? I mean, you're sitting at home, you see the storm playing out, terrible consequences. What makes you think, gee, I'm going to go rescue these people?
This is who I am in general. You know, I help people out on the daily. You know, the last storm we just recently had, one of my friend's plow trucks, actually, he was helping out a lady that needed dialysis. And she lives in off of Schiller Street in Lovejoy there. And he's like, listen, she needs to get the dialysis because the last storm. I was like, all right, tell her to be ready at 4 a.m. I'm going to take her whatever time she needed to. So moving from that storm, knowing so many people needed so much help and I could help somebody that needed dialysis like that to that extent, realizing when I moved into coming into the neighborhood this time, you know, pulling a generator, believe it or not. And at the time when I pulled a generator, I got waved down to help another gentleman that needed dialysis. So.
Well, William, you're a national treasure. I wish I lived in the same state as you. I feel a lot safer. Thanks for taking time out of being a superhero to talk to us. We really appreciate it.
No, I appreciate that. And I want to just thank all my friends for helping out, too. And, you know, when it got hectic, we had a good crew here to help me out. So,
well, from us here at Fox News, we thank you and we thank all of them, too. Keep at it. We appreciate
it. Thank you. I appreciate it. God bless.
Hey, Sean Hannity here. Hey, click here to subscribe to Fox News YouTube page and catch our hottest interviews and most compelling analysis. You will not get it anywhere else.